Hey guys, welcome back. So I'll be doing this challenge today in this video. Find the runner up score. So let's go for this. So here it is given that given a participant's score sheet for your university sports day, you are required to find runner up score. And given is any scores, total n scores will be given. Store them in a list and find the runner up guy. Okay, so n number of scores will be given. You have to make a list of it and find the runner up. So here input will be, first line will be n, how many number of scores, and in the second there is an array of n integers separated by spaces. So that will be the scores. So if okay, yeah, so constraints are there, n should be between 2 and 10. And the array values should be between 100 and minus 100. So output will be the runner up score. For example, if the value of n is 5, means 5 scores will be given. Here you can see 5 scores given in the format. This is the array space separated by spaces. So 2, 3, 6, 6, 5. These are the scores and it is stored in an array with separated by space. Here it is written. So we have to calculate the runner up guy. So here you can see maximum is 6, second maximum is 5, runner up will be 5. So these two are input and this is output. Okay, explanation is given the list 2 3 6 6 5, which is this guy. Maximum score is 6, second maximum is 5, hence 5 is the runner up. Okay, so here you can see n is taken from the user, and this is the array value stored in ARR, and this integer value is stored in n. So what I'll do is, first I'll convert this guy into list. First I'll check how the values look like. So I'll print both of them in different lines, and I'll run the code. So you can see that output is 5 and 2 3 6 6 5. Print ARR. Okay, split. So 5 input is this and output is this. It is already converted into list, is it correct? Okay, so let me it is already let me check again. So 2 3 6 6 5, it is already in list form. So it is given here, you have to store them in list. Okay, so anyway, I'll move on. So first I'll implement the constraint. If n value is less than 2 or n is greater than 10, I think, then it will print n is out of range. Okay, and there is a case for scores as well. So how should I do it? Okay, so I can use for loop. Let's say I in our array, so it will one by one go to the value of array and store in I. So if I is if now I, we can put the same constraint like here I have done it. So now I is less than minus 100 to 100, 2 to 10, minus 100, or I is greater than 100, then we'll print
print value of array, or I'll write array value is out of range. This is the constraint. So shall I check now? Okay, whether it is working fine or not, I'll see. So no response. Yeah, okay, so there is no printing or any sort of output I've given, that's why no response. So I'll comment it. So this is comment constraints. Okay, then comes the logic. I'll comment it logic. So what I'll do is I'll first arrange this values in from lower to higher, or higher to lower also, so both we can do. I'll take array dot sort I'm using. So if I'll use this and I'll print my array again, arr, run the code. So you can see it is 2, 3, 5, 6, 6. Okay, lowest to highest it is going. If you want this array to be in decreasing order, like it is increasing, right, from first to last. If you want from first to last decreasing, then we just have to write here reverse equal to true. Okay, capital T. So now if I'll run, so now you can see it is from increasing to decreasing. Okay, it is in decreasing order. So once I have my array is sorted in highest to lowest, now I have to check extract the second maximum guy. Okay, so for this array, what I'll do is for loop I'll use j, let's see, different variable I used here, but still I want to keep it different in arr. What it will do is it will just print the values of array. Okay, if I'll print just to show you guys, j, if I'll run, so you can see that it has arranged first this array 6, 6, 5, 3, 2, and then started printing it. Okay, because we have reversed here, right, we have reversed the array sorted the array. So that's how it is printing. So you can see that what is the value of j. So if I'll apply the condition. If j is less than, okay, I'll take one temp value, temporary variable to compare with, and it will start comparing all the values with my temporary variable. Okay, if j is less than temporary variable, then what should be the condition? I'll print j. Okay, so so initially if j value will be 6, it will not be less than 0. So else condition I'll give, else it will replace the value of temp is equal to j. Okay, so that's how I think it should work. Temp is equal to j, temp is 0. Oh, okay, So temp is 0 array. So I think I'm doing it fine, because if since we have 6, 6, 5, so 6 will be first value of j. It will compare it with temp. This if condition will fail and temporary variable will be replaced by value of j, which is 6. Next time j value will be 6, this condition will not be fulfilled, so again 6 will be stored in temp. Next value of j will be 5. 5 is less than 6, it will print 5, yeah, and then again it will grow. So I'll break it from here. Okay, break, because if I'll show you what will happen if this I'll do. So I hope you got the logic. So every time it is comparing with the temp variable, for first time I have kept my temp variable is equal to 0 and all the array values are comparing with 0. Okay, so first guy will be compared with 0. If it will satisfy, it will print the value of j, else it will replace the value of temporary variable with j. Okay, if I'll run this code, see what's the difference. If I'll not use, see, you can see the output. It keeps on comparing it till the last value, but what we want is we want the second maximum. Okay, so second maximum will come whenever for the first time, second max, whenever this condition will be fulfilled first time, then only we have to stop. So break will be used. So as soon as it will find this guy, it will break. It will not go to find 3 and 2, because next variables are 3 and 2, so they will replace and print it. That's why they have printed it. Okay, so I hope you got the feel of break. I'll run now. So now the test case is passed. Only 5 is printing. So as soon as it got the first less value, temporary less than first time, it this case was if case will be satisfy, then only it will break and it will come out here. It will not execute anything. Okay, here it will come out. So let's submit it. Okay, so one case is not satisfy, which one? So 5 minus 7. Here the array value can go in negative direction as well. Okay. So there should be extra case. No, we can take the temp variable as minus 100, because minimum will be minus 100 only. See, this is the here minus 100 value will be the minimum. So that's why the problem is we have implemented this code for positive values of array. But if negative values of array will come, then this case will be failed. That's why I have taken minus 100, because less than minus 100 is not allowed here, you can see. So every time the array values will be compared, will be compared from minimum most value. Okay, minimum most value is not 0, it is minus 100, and it will replace it. So I think this should work. This sample case is passed. If I'll submit it, yeah, all the cases are passed, total 9. Congratulations. So we have done this question. So I'll see you in the next problem.